Earlier tonight, you voted for Mel to be the seventh person to be evicted from the house. Here's how she took the news.
Melanie.
In 5 minutes' time, she'll be stepping out to give us the real story on the men inside the Big Brother house.
I'm shitting myself. I'm shitting myself.
You'll be fine. You'll be fine.
I'll fucking pass out.
Right, you won't.
Decide what to wear.
First outfit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, black's what
rock chick. That's good.
The girly pink one. Oh, it smells of mildew.
That suits your colour.
That's quite sassy, actually.
Yes. Oh, look. I like that.
I think black is better. This makes, I don't feel comfortable
with
this.
Okay.
Rocking eyes.
No. Oh, fucking hell, it's freezing.
Is it?
Yeah?
Yeah. I kind of like that.
We've got one fight.
Okay.
Am I going to put a smile on their faces now?
You ready? Throw the cigarettes.
What?
Garden's
crying, Mel, look.
Oh, I'm gonna miss you.
Don't
Mel.
Leave us, Mel.
I'm gonna miss you.
Everyone make sure they look after this one.
I will, yeah. Indeed. I know.
I'll take care of them, they're all right. Cheers to Melanie.
Yeah, to Melanie.
To all of you. Right. Enjoy your last week.
Look.
Big Brother house, and you've got just over 1 minute to say goodbye. When your minute's up, the door will open automatically and you must leave the house. Is that clear?
Yeah.
See you in a minute!
60 seconds.
Okay, the crowds here have been amazing this week. We've got fantastic outfits.
50 seconds.
Look at these guys over here. And we've got some fantastic Scousers here. Look at the Scousers. Absolutely awesome. We've got Ali G right there.
Seconds.
We're right over here, we've got some more fans, and of course the press. Hi, Mark, look, there's a boat on the river. Here are the friends. Hi,
seconds.
Guys. And here is Craig's family over here, and their babe, the sister. And look, there's
10,
Darren. Look, there's
9,
baby.
8, 7,
15 minutes.
6,
here are
5,
Mel's family.
4,
and friends.
3, Two.
Come on.
1. Melanie, will you please leave the Big Brother house? Melanie, will you please...
Go! Yeah, come on!
Don't stand anymore. As well, yeah?
I'm so sorry, but I'm gonna have to tear you away now. Jack! Gorgeous Jack! Now you're gonna see them all again in the studio in just a few seconds' time. Now down here, we've got, bless them, Craig's family and Darren's family. Into reality, if you
people,
can call this reality.
Yeah, odd. God.
Now, it must have been quite a mad time for you because it was your first time nominated and 4 days later, here you are. Now, how was it all, that experience of being nominated? What went through your mind?
It was the most exciting experience of my whole life.
Was it?
I wanted to go, I was happy to go, and I was really pleased to go, and I'm so missing I was ready to go, and I was so pleased.
It was a very emotional reunion there with your mum. You're obviously really chuffed to see it, because you live with her, don't you?
Yeah, I've really missed her. I've missed her so much. But I've missed everyone. I've missed all my friends, all my family. I've missed everything about my life.
What did you miss the most when you were in there? What kind of little luxuries did you miss?
I missed the fact that I could kind of walk away and just talk to people that were different, were away from the group.
Yeah,
I really
couldn't
missed
escape.
That. Couldn't escape. Mm. It was a very claustrophobic 8 weeks. It was really intense.
Well, let's take a quick look at the house, how we've seen it.
God.
This is what's happened in the last week.
Okay.
I know in here the tiniest little things
can annoy people.
Give us a double bicep, please. Oh! About me? Can we talk about me now?
I've been teaching Darren how to play guitar.
I can feel my genital present.
How bizarre.
Bobby, please, Dad, bro. Well, I'm a dad here, Bobby Dazzle.
This week, Big Brother is challenging you to a test of coordination, balance, and showmanship.
Energy!
Love you to bits.
Now, let's talk about the task.
Don't remind me! That was the worst task. It was the most challenging task we had. It was the most difficult task we had. All of us had to learn a totally new skill. And it was quite
But
it's
so
like
bad.
Unicycling. I think it's a nightmare. But you and Anna had such a tough time with it, and Darren and Craig kind of were okay.
The boys always do it though. We would.
No, go on.
We were too nervous, basically. Right. And once we got
so
on
scared.
It,
yeah, a person you're scared.
You should see the bruises that Anna got from that tricycle.
No, but I must say, watching it, I know it sounds rotten, but I was crying with laughter. I see Anna, but I'm sorry.
Cheers.
No, listen, I did want to give you one. No, not you. You were great. But I did want to say, but something that might surprise you, you actually lasted 7.2 seconds.
Really?
Yes!
Really?
Now, listen, let's take a quick look at the three housemates now. Look, there they are, relaxing.
Is that them right
That's
now?
Them right now, live. We've got Anna's in there. Craig, Craig, hey. Now, do you think they look the same on telly?
That's them.
Not even a little bit fatter. I always think I look fatter on telly.
That's them. They look That's lovely. Them. They look great.
Now
I'm going to miss them.
Now, why? Because you said you kind of quite enjoyed the whole experience.
Yeah.
Why did you go in for Big Brother? What did you hope to glean out of it?
I hoped, it may sound like a bit of a cliche, but I hoped to try and understand myself a bit better.
And do you think that's happened?
Without question. I went through highs, lows, and of the most extreme you can ever imagine. I mean, it was an absolute rollercoaster of emotions, and I loved every minute of it.
And what do you think you learned about yourself then, while you were in there?
I don't know. I'm going to watch the tapes and find out. I'm dreading it. I'm really dreading it.
But you know what's really interesting is that you can watch the tapes, but people have been watching it 24 hours a day on the internet. I mean, it's been like an incredible response. It's been amazing. Now, who do you think you're going to miss the most now that you've left?
Without question, Anna.
You really bonded, didn't you, over the past
Incredibly.
Weeks?
It was really strange because to start with, we really didn't bond at all. Yeah. She was really kind of getting on with a lot of other people. I was getting on with other people. And it was only, and we actually talked about it, it was only 3 weeks ago that we really had our first proper chat. And over the last 3 weeks, we've really bonded. And we realised we're actually quite similar.
How do you think she's going to cope without you?
She's going to have a tough time. She is. I think
she's going to sleep in the boys' room tonight.
No. Smells in there. They fart in there.
Oh, no.
Fart and burping.
Oh, no. But it was tidier than yours.
No, it was.
I was in there today.
No, you were.
I was. You know the people making that big racket in the camera run?
Yeah,
that was
you.
Me. Anyway. Now, Mel. You really, really bonded with Anna, but you were also, undoubtedly, a big hit with the boys. Let's take a look.
Why do birds so every time you are near, just like
blooded males, and they all did get very, very frisky. Now, all of them at some point gave you some kind of, you know, sexual attention. Now, is it hard to, how do you deal with that? Because you've got nowhere to go. You have to be kind of firm, but like nice, because you've got to live with them.
You just deal with it. It was fine. I mean, the thing is, everyone's so nervous because they know that so many people are watching. So the minute you hear a kind of whiff of a no, they kind of go, oh, okay, fine, that's fine. So they kind of really back off. Yeah, it was fine.
I loved Craig when you were sitting on his knee. Anyway, I'll talk about it.
Moving swiftly on.
Now, you did kiss Andy. Now, you did kiss Andy, and I do think we'll have to take a second look.
I thought you might.
Yeah.
I thought you might enjoy it.
I've wanted to do that the whole time I've been here.
Now, even I was cringy at that.
I know, stop.
I'm sorry, Mel. But okay. Did you actually mean for that to happen?
That happened. That was actually the lowest point
for you. No, no, not. No, no, she didn't mean kissing Andy. No, I know what you meant.
No, what I meant was I was really upset.
At your lowest ebb.
Yeah, I bonded with Andy. He went to the same university as me. We got on really well. We knew some of the same people. So it was really kind of strange. And we bonded so well. And I could not believe he was going on second nomination. And I didn't feel like I had anyone I could particularly talk to then.
So you felt like you were losing your only friend?
I was really, really upset. I spent the whole, you haven't seen it, but I spent the whole night crying. I was so upset seeing go. It was horrible.
But then, Irish charmer Thomas. Now, he left. And here you are in the diary room talking about how upset you were.
Tom is someone that I'd really, really like to see again. Really like to see. And we've got things, and you know, I feel like also I'd really like to sit down and have a really good chat with him, kind of outside Big Brother, because even though you can talk quite freely, you can't talk as freely as you'd like to be able to. And you can't say everything you'd like to say.
Now, in this week's task, you were talking about making a newspaper, and you were talking about various articles about what you thought was happening on the outside. Now, what did you say you thought Kaggy was doing?
Kaggy had a contract with some lipstick company.
Okay, well, you're not far wrong. She is a huge celebrity.
Is she?
She's made it into all the papers.
Okay.
But sometimes for the kind of wrong reasons. Here she is.
Okay.
Running around on the floor with Nicola at a party, having flaws. Vanessa Felter.
No!
They drunken sprawl and they knock over
brilliant.
Vanessa. Now, here's my own personal favourite. Let's take a look at what's happened to Nick since he was evicted from the house. There he is. At the premiere of Snatch with Brad Pitt, Guy Ritchie, Vinnie Jones and Dominic Monaghan. Front page of a national newspaper. And you know the eviction. You know when you said, what did you say to Darren when he said, oh, it'll have been big news?
I said, no, not at all. It'd have been easy. It would have swept past. No one noticed.
The front page of every single national newspaper.
Oh, well.
And what do you think happened to Tom?
I think he went home.
Okay, let's see what happened to Tom. Posing in the paper! Women throw themselves at me, but I'm saving myself for Mel. Now, you went earlier today into the diary room with some items that people had left behind. And some things from Nick and from Claire.
Yeah.
And some stuff from Tom with the red shorts. But you said you were keeping a T-shirt of his, didn't you?
Yeah.
Because you wanted to give it to him in person.
Yeah.
Is that still true?
That is. It's in my suitcase.
Here he is! It's Tom! I can't believe. And you know what's going to be nice though is afterwards you guys are going to be able to have a kind of chat together. You know, at least there's somebody on the outside that knows what you're going through right now. Well,
there's lots of people on the outside that know what I'm going through.
Yeah, but somebody that was in there and shared it with you.
Yeah, it's fun.
He's right here. So how's your week been?
Hectic, unbelievable, all over the place, partying everywhere.
And what's it like when you walk around in the streets?
People are coming up to you. It's unbelievable.
You're not going to believe it. Now, you've seen Kaggy and Nikki out on the town, and now it's your turn, because we've got a special, special gift for you. We've organised for two tickets to go and see Bobby Davro. In the Christmas panto in Woking.
Yeah.
No expense spared. I would have wanted to come with you, but I thought you might like to take Tom.
Great.
Thanks.
What do you think? This is a good idea.
Touched.
Okay. Now, I thought you might be. Mel, just wanted to say thank you so much for being part of the Big Brother experience and for lighting up our screen. Like to commemorate your amazing stay with some of your best bits from the house.
Good evening. I'm Crystal McFeisty,
And this is the BBTTCH4 News. You watch me. I've got my tattoo, lots of legs, my breasts, and lots of heads, and lots of bums.
Best thing come to me when I've been in here is the fact that I've met so many different people from different walks of life that I would never, ever, ever have met before. You shouldn't be doing that.
That's nasty.
I would like a full body massage, please.
Good night.
Smack my hand.
Yeah,
smack my hand. I'm so sorry. Now, you know that beautiful eye that we have on the eye dent, the Big Brother eye that winks? Guess who that is? It's Mel!
Oh!
It's Mel's eye that we've been using. You'll see. Okay. Watch the show. Right. Now, listen, guys. One final question before we go. I want to know who you want to win Big Brother.
I knew you'd ask me this. I'm not gonna ask. Only joking. I want Anna to win.
You do?
I really, really want Anna to win. She deserves to win. And can I just say,
yeah,
message from Anna. She loves her mum, she loves her dad and auntie. And
what's that t-shirt about?
I'm not telling you.
Anniversary.
You wait and find out. No, you wait and find out.
Okay.
She loves you, her mum, dad and tea, and she can't wait to see you.
And Tom, who do you want to win? You've seen a bit.
From the opinion from most people on the street, Craig. Yeah!
Oh, go on. OK, we all know if they'll get their wishes in a week's time. There are the final three. Darren, Anna, Craig must be somewhere else. And the phone lines are now reopening for the most important vote of the series. But this time you're voting for the person you want to win. First up, we have the nun without a habit. Vote for her to win on 090-11-980-101. And we can find out what that t-shirt means. Next, we have Liverpool's sexy scouser. Craig, if you think his big biceps deserve big bucks, vote for him on 090-11-980-102. Finally, Big Daddy Darren, if you want to show him the prize money, call 090-11-980-103. See you next week!
Show's over. Night night.
Okay.
Hey, 11:33.
Bobby Davro, they're taking the piss, aren't they?